गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने भूमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्यावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ब्रह्मण विदाति पूर्व वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदिवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुक्षुरुवै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। आम्नायान्तिक संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So continuing the itare upadeshadhikaranam, just a moment. For some reason my PC has become slow. I think I opened a huge PDF file by mistake. To get to this PDF, I opened the first available PDF that was a huge file, so I think it's consuming resources. Just a moment. Yeah. So, in the itara vyapadeshadhikaranam, we saw adhikantu bheda nirdeshat. So, there is definitely adhika dharma of sarvajnyatvam ityadi in Paramatma Parabrahma. And thereby there is definitely bheda in samsari avastha between the samsara avastha between the brahma tattva and the jiva, brahma and jiva. And what kind of a bheda is this? It has nothing to do with moksha. In the sense, moksha avastha there won't be bheda, and it is not that in the samsara avastha there is real bheda. So it has nothing to do with reality as it exists. It has nothing to do with paramartha. So paramarthata, although there is abheda, there is kalpita bheda in samsara avastha. That was established by adhikamtu bheda nirdeshat. Now further, continuing the same adhikarana, दि पूर्वपक्षी सेज ननु एकरूप ब्रह्मणः जगत्कारणत्वे सति। ही ऑब्जेक्ट्स बाय सेइंग इफ एट ऑल दिस ब्रह्म इज एकमेव अद्वितीय ब्रह्म, एकरूप ब्रह्म, देयर इज नो सेकंड टू ब्रह्म, एंड इफ दैट काइंड ऑफ अ ब्रह्म हैज जगत्कारणत्वम, मीनिंग इज द कारण ऑफ अवर प्रपंच, then karyavaichitrim nasyat. In the jagat which is karya of this ekarupa brahma, you won't have variety. Karya naam vaichitrim nasyat, vichitrata nasyat. There cannot be such a tending to infinity kind of variety. You cannot even try to understand the prapancha in all its various manifest forms in this ever expanding universe scientifically in a single janma or in even in multiple janmas. You cannot even imagine the kind of varieties there that are existent. If you pick any species also and look among the varieties in those, you pick trees, how many different kind of trees are there? If you start studying these in one lifetime, you cannot become an expert and say that I know each and everything about all kinds of trees. Perhaps so with multiple PhDs so many theses and publications, you may claim so, but still there will always be something that you have not seen, something you have not experimented with. So this is about one species. Now expand this idea to multiple things, padarthas, multiple species also. Pick birds. How many varieties of birds are there? Some have become extinct. They may come back. Sometime we don't know how. So all this is possible, and such a vaichitram, vichitrata of karya, prapancha, cannot be if Brahma is one without a second. If at all there is a karya possible, then you should have one kind of a karya from that karana. This is the objection made by the Purva Pakshi. Therefore, what? Since karya vaichitram is there, anyatha anupapatti. Since karya vaichitram is there, therefore, your Brahma cannot be eka rupa Brahma. So you can see some kind of anyatha anupapatti also. Na syaditi dosham drishtantena pariharati. Using an example, the Siddhanti says that, oh, it is possible. It is possible. In the loka itself, you see such example. And take a simple example. Any samagri that you use to cook, is it that you can make only one thing out of it? Those who are expert chefs, they know what all to make from a single karana. Not single karana, there are other things also, of course. But even a particular karana can become a single karana, can become a basis for multiple karyas. Anyway, maybe instead of imagining some examples which may or may not fit, let's look at what the vritti says or the sutra says. Ashma adivaccha tadanupapattihi. Ashmadi vachcha tadanupapattihi. So ashmadi vachcha tadanupapattihi. Tadanupapatti is what? Tat is that dosha. Karya vaichitriyam na syat ekarupa brahmana jagat karanatve sati was the dosha pointed out. That dosha is tat. So dosha anupapattihi, doshasya anupapattihi, kutaha, meaning anupapattihi, this dosha is not tenable. You cannot raise such an objection. Why? Because it is this ekarupa brahma giving rise to vichitra karya is ashma adivat. Ashma is a stone or earth, basically something which will come out of prithvi. So the prithvi will become the basis rather. So prithvi, ashma is generally considered as stone, but here you can take it as prithvi. What all comes from the prithvi? When you dig the earth, you are trying to find minerals. And this particular prithvi, which is what, if you look at the Mahabhuta, prithvi is one Mahabhuta, Pancha Mahabhuta naam Madhye. That prithvi is ekarupa. From that prithvi, what all has come about? You ask the people who are digging earth to find something, meaning who are mining. They are not mining only for one thing. There are companies which mine for only one thing, iron ore or something like that. But then there are companies which mine for multiple things. When you are digging in a particular area, if there is variety of minerals possible that can come out of this single prithvi, then they'll mine for those also. So similar is this. From one ekarupa prithvi, from ekarupa ashma, multiple minerals or multiple kind of products come out. There may be processing needed, but then that is irrelevant to the discussion, because there are multiple karyas from a ekarupa karana we see in loka. So thereby योर ऑब्जेक्शन इज इनवैलिड तस्य दोषस्य अनुपपत्ति ही तदनुपपत्ति ही वृत्ति से एक पृथ्वी जन्यानाम यथा अश्मनाम वज्र वैडुर्यादि भेदेन वैचित्र्यम सो ओके सो अश्मादि वच्च मीन्स अश्मादि कार्यवत अश्मा इज नॉट पृथ्वी सो अश्मा स्टोन इज फाइन सो आई वॉज थिंकिंग दैट अश्मा कैन यूज एज सो वॉट इज बींग सेड इज दैट द जेम स्टोन्स सो एग्जाम्पल इज जेम स्टोन्स सो स्टोन्स आर जेम स्टोन्स बट इन द स्टोन सो इट इज अ स्टोन फाइनली से फॉर अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट नो जेम आई मीन डज नॉट नो वॉट काइंड ऑफ जेम्स आर देर डज नॉट वैल्यू देम इन फैक्ट दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल यूज एल्सवेयर बाय भगवान भाष्यकार ऑल्सो एंड अदर प्लेसेस ऑल्सो इन प्रकरण ग्रंथाद इत्यादिषु दृश्यते दैट समबडी हु हैज आई थिंक इन छांदोग्य भाष्य समवेयर इट कम्स इन षष्ठो अध्याय एज टू अ पर्सन हु हैज ज्ञान ऑफ द जेम्स He knows the value of a particular stone. Otherwise, it will remain a stone in others' hands who are ajnanis in the area of gems. What they call it, gemology, or I'm not sure. So, in that area, the one who has jnana, he knows the value. Otherwise, it's a stone. So, that way you can take this. So, I'll go back and correct the statement I made in the... Sutra. What I said is right there. From Prithvi, the stones come out, but then the you can say that from the stone themselves are of a variety of types. They are available in Prithvi, but Ashma is stone. So Ashma divachya means so many karyas are there, although they are all stones. So Eka Prithvi Janyana. These are all found in Prithvi. So in the Prithvi. When you are looking for Prithvi Rupa stones, then you process them and then cut into gems. They are all Eka Rupa. So, Yatha Ashmanam Vajra Vaiduryadi Bhedena Vaichitriyam. So, the same thing, same Prithvi singular will give rise to Vajra Ityadi. So, you can get a diamond out of it. And then, not only one particular type of diamond, there may be many types of diamonds. So many gems can come out of a single prithvi. Similarly, so many vichitra karyas can come out of Eka Rupa Brahma. This is the response given by the Siddhanti to the Purva Paksha pointing out the dosha. Therefore, what there is no dosha. तथा ब्रह्म कार्याणां स्वरूप वैचित्र्यं युज्यते एव इट इज लॉजिकल यू हैव टू जस्ट एक्सटेंड इट टू एक रूप ब्रह्म फ्रॉम द एग्जांपल ऑफ एक रूप पृथ्वी एक रूपा पृथ्वी अतः तदनुपपत्ति मीन्स तस्य उक्त दोषस्य अनुपपत्ति व्हाट वाज द उक्त दोष दैट देयर कैन नॉट बी वैरायटी इफ द ब्रह्म इज कारण एंड दैट ब्रह्म विच इज एक रूप ब्रह्म तस्मात् जीव अभिन्न ब्रह्मवादी समन्वय न विरुध्यते इति सिद्धम देयर बाय वॉट एवर वॉज द उक्त दोष बाय द पूर्वपक्षी दैट वॉज ओनली टू शो समन्वय विरोध दैट समन्वय विरोध इज नॉट देयर देयर बाय एक रूप ब्रह्म इज द विचित्र कार्य विचित्र प्रपंच कारण And this is the Tatparya Vishaya of entire Shruti, all the Vedanta Vakyas, this is the Samanvaya and there is no Virodha to this, it is not compromised at all. Through this the Adhikarana is over, now the next Adhikarana is Upasamhara Darshana Adhikaranam. Upasamhara Darshana. इट इज इंट्रोड्यूस बाय सेइंग पूर्वम औपाधिक जीव भेदाद हिताकरणादि दोषः नास्ति इत्युक्तम् व्हाट वाज सेड बाय द सिद्धांति अर्लियर दैट दिस हिताकरणादि दोषः व्हाट इज द हिताकरणादि दोषः वी सॉ यस्टरडे दैट हित अकर्ण एंड आदि पदेन यू कैन से बाय नञ्व्यत्यास the same word or adhipadena you can take as ahita karana, not doing good and ending up doing something which is evil rather. This kind of a dosha would accrue to Brahma if Brahma is jiva abhinna or jiva is Brahma abhinna and Brahma is jagat karana. Then jiva will become jagat karana and jiva doshas will accrue to Brahma, as in Brahma will have created this kind of a dukkha roopa samsara where he becomes a jiva. So he is afflicting himself with adversities. Even being sarvajna, while being sarvajna, he is torturing himself. So how can Brahma be a sadist like that? This kind of a dosha was hitakaranadi dosha. That kind of a dosha isn't there. Why? Because upadika jiva bheda is a kalpita, upadikrita jiva bheda is there from Brahma. Jiva is different from Brahma in samsara avastha. So he didn't know any better when, if at all you say jiva created, then that jiva who was one with Brahma, that kind of a jiva would have created. Hypothetically, always jiva has been one with Brahma, even in the samsara avastha, but due to avidya, kalpita bheda is there and he thinks himself as samsari. So when the prapancha is created, this jiva is not there. This jiva is one with Brahma, with the avidya as bija, which is not manifest yet. So he didn't know any better. If at all there is something that has to be claimed hypothetically, we can say he didn't know any better because he was in Brahma Swarupa. And as soon as this prapancha was created, the avidya which has never gone manifest itself, and then his jiva bhava, the anadi jiva bhava, suddenly got superimposed in one amsha of this Ishvara. Because amsha amshi bhava can be said to be there in the samsara avastha. Kalpita again, all this is kalpita. Thereby upadika means upadikrita jiva bhedad, brahmana jiva bhedad, hita karanadi dosha nasti ityuktam. So therefore there is no hita akarana or ahita karana ityadi doshas. Samprati, now what is said? Samprati upadito api brahmanaha vibhaktam karanadikam nasti brahmananatva bhavat iti pratyudharana sangatya idamaha. There is a typo here. Idam, it should be idamaha. Sangatya idamaha. The is missing. So upadita api brahmana, this Brahma who is in the jiva form, why? Because of the maya upadi, avidya upadi, antakarana ityadi, the shariratraya becomes upadi. Thereby also Brahma, brahmana vibhaktam karanadikam nasti. Even then Brahma will not end up having these karanas which are there in jiva. Jiva has karanas, but Brahma does not have karana. We have seen this in the in Vichara Sagara and even in during maybe Adhyasa Bhashya. What is the difference between samsari jiva and asamsari jiva? Or rather, this jiva and Brahma during samsara itself. When do we say that jiva is Brahma and jiva is samsari jiva, asamsari Brahma and samsari jiva? The same jiva, we say asamsari jiva and samsari jiva. We can say that. How do we say that? When all these upadhis, we should not say upadhis, all these shariras, shariratraya, become an upadhi to jiva. Upadhi is incidental, therefore whatever is incidental will not affect the jiva swarupa, therefore jiva will remain Brahma. When does he become a samsari jiva? He is asamsari, but when does he become samsari? When these very shariratrayas, this very shariratraya, these very shariras, or this very shariratraya. Shariratraya being a triad, it will be a singular. So when this shariratraya becomes a visheshana and not an upadhi, becomes an adjective to this entity, jiva who is brahma bhinna, when this shariratraya becomes a visheshana, then he becomes samsari jiva. Otherwise, he is asamsari jiva. Why? Because all these are incidental upadhis. All the shariras or the shariratraya is an upadhi. So, samprati upadhita api brahmana vibhaktam karanadikam nasti. So, this upadhi is there, but upadhi is what? It is agantuka, or it is what? It is kalpita. There is a, with the upadhi also, there is a kalpita sambandha. Everything is kalpita. It is not a visheshana. Therefore, Brahma has nothing to do with the kalpito karanadikam. So, vibhaktam karanadikam nasti. There is no separate. There are no separate karanas. And Brahma nanatva bhavad is a hetu. Why? Brahma is one. So, even if you say there are karanas, these karanas are what? Are they Brahma bhinna or Brahma bhinna? Either you have to say they are different from Brahma or they are not different from Brahma. But Brahma is one. Ekarupa, you yourself have objected, saying Brahma is Ekarupa, meaning hypothetically at least, for that objection you accept that Brahma is Ekarupa. And if you are Astika, then that hypothesis is not there, because Shruti is a Pramana and you accept that Brahma is Ekarupa. There is nowhere in the Shruti that another Brahma is talked about. Another jiva may be talked about. Whether it is kalpita or not, for your darshana, we don't want to bring that into discussion. But Brahma nanatva is not mentioned at all. Brahma ekatva is mentioned in Shruti. And this should be agreeable to all darshanas. All darshanakaras or darshana followers, darshanikas. Thereby, Brahma nanatva bhavad, karana is not possible to Brahma. Karanadi, whatever it is, sharira, nothing is possible. Thereby, vibhaktam karanadikam nasti. Iti pratyudarana sangatya idamaha. With this, with a counter example, the upasamhara darshanadikaranam comes up. And what is upasamhara here? Upasamhara, generally when we see in let's say your shadlingas for finding out tatparya, there upakrama upasamharau is the first linga. There upasamhara means conclusion. So generally we take the word upasamhara to mean conclusion, but here upasamhara means sangraha, samagrinam sangraha. All the ingredients, when they are brought together, there is a grouping of these set of ingredients, which will become karana to create some karya. So that upasamhara is sangraha, grouping together of all the samagris is meant by the word upasamhara here. So the sutra is upasamhara darshanan neti chenna kshiravaddhi. Upasamhara darshanan neti chenna kshiravaddhi. Upasamhara darshanat. Due to our seeing upasamhara. Loki darshanat. Whenever something has to be created, you need all the ingredients. If you are cooking something, then all the ingredients are needed. Whether you group them together or you have kept them in separate boxes and put it directly in the cooking pan, cooking vessel, whatever is your style, still the ingredients are brought together, be it in the cooking vessel. Or even if they are in separate boxes, still they are collected. You know what you want to cook, so you bring all of them together. It is always possible that when you are cooking that something is missing. But a pot maker cannot make such a mistake. When the pot maker is making a pot, he needs clay, he needs danda, he needs chakra, he needs jala. all this is a set of ingredients upasamhara. So samagrinam upasamharasya darshanat loke na iti chet. Therefore what? Na. Kinna. So thereby Brahma cannot be upadana, because you see many things have to come together, and Brahma is ekarupa Brahma. Now this Brahma nanatva bhava, Brahma is, I explained this from the Siddhanti perspective, but this is pratyudharana sangati, means is an objection. So again, little sleepy, honestly. I had to attend some function online, so I slept late, but I didn't want to skip this class, so I didn't get time to look it up further before class, and it is a little tricky here. And since the vision is Vedanta, as before, what has happened is that somebody had asked me to slow down also, so you have to explain what is coming up next, an introduction to what is coming up. But I prefer to read the sentence and then explain. But what I have been doing is that I read parts of the sentences and explain. Thereby, I didn't read this as Pratyurana Sanghati. So of course, it can be explained from Siddhanti perspective also. But it has been said, Brahman Anatma Bhava. See, I can explain from the Siddhanti perspective, which I have done. But here, it is a Pratyurana Sanghati, means counter example. If it is a counter example, it is a question by the Puropakshi. So let me reinterpret it from the Puropakshi's perspective. So vibhaktam karanadikam nasti can be siddhanta, we agree. So we'll say yes, we agree. But what is the objection there is, he says that since the karanas are not there, what are these karanas? For a manushya to do something, some karanas are needed. You need indriyas and you need karmendriyas also, meaning jnanendriyas and karmendriyas also. So with jnanendriyas, you'll think what all I need to create a karya. And with karmendriya, you will start acting out. So you will put this, while cooking, you will put this particular ingredient at a particular time in the vessel. You will put oil, whatever. Similarly, kulala, what does he do? He knows how much water to add. He will use his karanas, he will use his hand. And then he will put some water, he will measure that and put some water in the clay. Or he will know by experience how much water to put, what kind of thickness is needed for the mud to become clay, and then he can shape it so that it does not fall apart. It should be wet enough that it does not fall apart, and it should not be so wet, it should be dry enough that it can be shaped. So what is the objection by the Puropakshi is that this is an objection. So it is not a Siddhanta, it is a Siddhanta, but that Siddhanta is used as an objection by the Puropakshi. So he will say Brahman Anatva Bhavad, we say yes. And by that hetu, he will say, upadita brahmana api vibhaktam karanadikam nasti. So here in the samsara avastha, when Brahma has become jiva, this jiva swarupa is brahmatvam. But then upadhi, upadita bheda asti. So he is taking this upadhi, let it not be visheshana, but it is an upadhi. And this upadita bheda, what we have said is that upadita brahmanaha samsaritvam, meaning kalpita samsaritvam, because upadita, visheshana, had it been there, then it would have been real. We are saying that upadhi is there, therefore there is no samsaritvam of Brahma, but there is kalpita bheda, and thereby in the samsara avastha there can be bheda. That is what we had said. This jiva abhinna Brahma vadi samanvaya kinna viruddhyate, we have said that earlier we have said, if you look at kalpita bheda madaya sarvasya asankarya upapatti, vyavastha upapatti, this vyavastha of samsarana also can be explained by taking upadhi or kalpita bheda between jiva and Brahma. Now the Puropakshi is saying, even if you take this upadita bheda, means kalpita bheda of Brahma and jiva, so this Brahma is upadhi krita jiva, and then this jiva, how will he have vibhaktam karanadikam? We are saying, okay, he really does not have. Now, his question is not whether really it is there. He says, even in upadhi, how can he have this vibhakta karana ityadi? Meaning what? ही सेज दैट जस्ट लाइक द जीवा इन संसार अवस्था लेट्स से ही हैज टेकन द रोल ऑफ कुलाला देन ही नीड्स कर्णास टू गेट समथिंग डन मीनिंग फॉर कार्य ही नीड्स सम कर्णास नॉट ओनली मटीरियल कॉज एंड ही इज हिमसेल्फ एन एफिशियंट कॉज बींग अ चैतन्य जीवा चेतन जीवा ही विल ऑल्सो नीड वेरियस सामग्रीज कर्णास आर नीडेड सहकारी कारणास इज आर नीडेड देन पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ कर्णा इज नीडेड टू बिकम अ कारण दंड इत्यादि आर नीडेड सो जस्ट लाइक समथिंग एल्स इज नीडेड दिस ब्रह्मनानात्व भावाद एकरूप ब्रह्मण कर्णादिकम न संभवति दैट इज द ऑब्जेक्शन ही सेज दैट फॉर ब्रह्मा टू क्रिएट द प्रपंच विल ही और विल ही नॉट नीड हेल्प फ्रॉम समथिंग एल्स सम अदर थिंग एन असिस्टेंट वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू से विल ही नॉट नीड हेल्प ही नीड हेल्प बिकॉज वी हैव सीन इन लोका दैट ऑल्दो कुलाला हिमसेल्फ इंडिविजुअली कैन क्रिएट अ पॉट ही नीड्स दंड चक्र मे बी इनसेंशियंट बट स्टिल दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कुलाला ही नीड्स समथिंग एल्स नाउ दिस ब्रह्मा विच इज नॉट नाना इट इज एक रूप देर वाय देर आर नो विभक्त करणादिकम विच शुड बी एक्सेप्टेबल टू यू Honestly, we'll say yes, it is Siddhanta. But in Kalpita Avastha, Kalpita Bheda is possible, Kalpita Karana is also possible, that will be our answer. But the Purapakshi is objecting that Karanadikam Nasti Vibhaktam, Brahmana Vibhaktam, separate from Brahma. Therefore, Karana's lacking, how will he create a Karya? How will Brahma create a Karya? Because Karana's are lacking. What will he use? How will he mix up something and create Prapancha? This is the idea. Behind that, Pratyudharana Sangati. That objection with a counter thought. So, sorry for that error as seeing from the Siddhanti perspective because generally as a Vedantin you start seeing Siddhanta everywhere because Advaita Vedanta can explain almost anything as Siddhanta. Meaning, in Siddhanta I can explain anything and everything. See, that is the Vedanti statement. So, Upasamhara Darshanat Na Iti Chet means this Brahma cannot become, Eka Rupa Brahma cannot become Karana for not only Vichitra Karya, but not even a single Karya. For a single Karya, Eka Rupa Karya also, this Brahma cannot become a Karana because he has, to put it in a very raw fashion, Karmendriyas aren't there. At least Karmendriyas are not there. And nothing else is there rather. So, Nothing else is there. Danda chakradi vat sahakari karanani nasti. Nasanti. So there are no things available to mix up and create as though. Therefore, Brahma jagat karanam ekarupa Brahma karyasya prapanchasya karanam na bhavati. Jagat karanam na bhavati. Iti chet, that is the objection. If that be the question, then na is the answer by the Siddhanti. Why? Kshiravadhi. Kshiravadhi, what is Kshiravadhi? Kshira is milk. He, indeed, Eka Rupa Kshira, does milk have karanas? Milk is one. Now, look at this. It's a very interesting example to which there can be an objection. So, Kshiravadhi means the way the milk curdles. Suddenly, there can be an objection. Oh, milk does not have karanas, but a person who curdles the milk has karanas because he'll have to add curd. He or she will have to add curd to milk and leave it overnight. Therefore, karanas are there for an efficient cause who is curdling the milk. Somebody has to add curd. The answer is that the example is not adding curd to milk. If at all it is that, then why doesn't the milk curdle immediately? Let's say I want to eat something, I want to eat curd rice and I have only one spoon or two spoons of curd left. I have liters of milk. Can I say, okay, I'm hungry, I'll eat curd rice and add two spoons of curd or sufficient amount of milk is needed, that much curd is needed, that much amount of milk I'll add to this curd mix it up very well and start eating. No, it will still be what? It will be some kind of a mixed up curd in milk kind of a rice. It won't be curd rice. Why? Because the milk won't curdle. So what is the example, real example here? The real example is after somebody adds curd to this milk, based on the season or based on the temperature, weather conditions, there are certain number of hours needed for the milk to curdle. Now, does the milk have to do something? Milk becomes curd. So, what karanas does the milk use to make curd? Nothing else is needed. It curdles. So, that is the example. At least in the loka, darshana is like that. We see that there is nothing that milk has to bring together. Something else is needed. Something else is needed. Nothing else is needed. The milk curdles by itself. That time after the curd has been added, in that time what happens? It is all without any karanas. So this can be the example. So sentient Brahma has done something and given time, the entire prapancha will shape up. That's why this ever expanding, if you take an example and take it literally and apply it to the prapancha, the way scientists say that this is an ever expanding prapancha, so the curdling is going on. So assume that this Brahma becoming this prapancha, ever expanding prapancha, the curdling is ever going on. It is always from kalpa to kalpa, the curdling is going on without any karanas needed. Why? Chiravat. So that is our sutra. Phalam tu puravat says the vritti, meaning same thing, samanvaya asiddhi and samanvaya siddhi as per the puravapakshi and siddhanti respectively. Na Brahma upadanam kartruva. Both objections are taken by the vrittikara, by the author of the vritti. Vrittikara has a different meaning. So Brahma is not jagad upadana, material cause, or karta, kartru, neuter. So Brahma is not the jagat karta, efficient cause, intelligent cause. Why? Asayatvat sammatavat iti nyayena. So he says sammatavat, do you accept that the kulala, the pot maker, potter, has help from danda chakra? And if you want a sentient being, we'll say okay, he uses a donkey also to bring the mud to the clay, or mud basically, which will convert into clay to wherever he is making the pot. So there are some sahakari karanas. These sahakari karanas are missing in Brahma, or in the case of Brahma prakriti. So asayatvat is a hetu, but sammatavat is acceptable. So sammatavat means whatever is acceptable to both parties who are discussing or debating. So sammatavat, what is acceptable? Asaya kulalavat is sammatavat. The kulala who has no sahakari karana, meaning danda and chakra are missing, he has no means to bring clay otherwise or bring mud, will he be able to create a pot? He won't be able to create a pot. Then will he be the efficient cause for pot? There is no pot itself to be created. There is no possibility of a pot being created. Therefore, he cannot be an efficient cause also. So he is not karta. He himself, can he become an upadana karana? He cannot become an upadana karana. The clay is missing. Therefore, sammatavata, like a kulala with who has no ingredients available to create a pot, similarly, this Brahma not having ingredients available, asayatvat, upadana or nimitta karana bhavitum na arhati, cannot become either of the karanas that you claim Brahma to be. Iti nyayena asayad brahmana jagat sargam bruvan samanvaya virudhyate nava iti sandehe prapte. So same as earlier, if there is a doubt, what kind of a doubt? This samanvaya which is stating what bruvan, this samanvaya states what? इट इज एस्टैब्लिशिंग जगत सर्गम ब्रह्मणः. दिस क्रिएशन ऑफ प्रपंच इज फ्रॉम ब्रह्म. विच ब्रह्म? असाह्य ब्रह्म. असाह्या असाह्यात ब्रह्मण. ब्रह्मण इज पंचमी हियर, पंचमी एक वचन. असाह्यात ब्रह्म हु हैज नो सहकार कारणाज अवेलेबल, दैट असाह्य ब्रह्म, हेल्पलेस ब्रह्म. दैट ब्रह्म इज लिटरली वॉट असाह्य इज, वॉट हेल्पलेस. अहम असाह्य मीनिंग आई एम हेल्पलेस, आई कांट इवन इंटेंडिंग टू हेल्प यू, आई कांट हेल्प यू बिकॉज रिसोर्सेज आर मिसिंग. दैट्स वॉट वी से, रिसोर्सेज आर नॉट सफिशियंट. आई वुड लाइक टू डू दाना बट आई माई सेल्फ आई एम स्ट्रगलिंग टू मेक एंड्स मीट, हाउ विल आई डू दाना? असाह्य हम कॉज ऑल दिस इज ओके बट आई कांट हेल्प यू. सो सिमिलर दिस ब्रह्म इज हेल्पलेस इन क्रिएटिंग प्रपंच. सो युअर समन्वय सेइंग वॉट दिस असाह्य ब्रह्म इज द क्रिएटर ऑफ ब्रह्म. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ अ समन्वय विच इज स्टेटिंग दिस, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ समन्वय विरुध्यते न वा, इज इट काउंटर्ड विद दिस असाह्यत्व हेतु और नॉट इति संदेह प्राप्ति. वेन सच अ डाउट इज रेज उपसंहार दर्शनात् लोके कुलालस्य कर्तृः कर्तुः दंडचक्रादि उपसंहार दर्शनात् मृदो वा उपादानस्य स्वभिन्न कुलालादि सहाय दर्शनात् सहाय दर्शनात् तद उभय विलक्षणस्य ब्रह्मण न जगत कर्तृत्वं उपादानत्वं वा संभवति. सो ब्रह्म कैनॉट बिकम जगत कारण ऑफ ईदर टाइप, मटीरियल और एफिशिएंट, उपादान कारण और निमित्त कारण. व्हाई ही सेज पूर्व पक्षी दैट देर इज अ विरोध उपसंहार दर्शनात्. उपसंहार है संग्रह, सामग्री नाम समग्र संग्रह. सो लोके कुलालस्य कर्तुः, दिस कुलाला हु इज द कर्ता, घटकर्ता. सो दिस घटकार कुलाला इज सीन इन द वर्ल्ड एज वॉट, ही ब्रिंग्स टुगेदर. उपसंहार इज सीन, ही मेक्स अ संग्रह, ही ग्रुप्स टुगेदर दंड चक्र आदि. सो ही ब्रिंग्स अ दंड इज नीडेड टू मूव दी चक्र, एंड चक्र इज नीडेड ऑन विच ही प्लेस दिस क्ले, लंप ऑफ क्ले, एंड शेप इट अप. सो इट हैज टू, चक्र हैज टू बी रोटेटेड, सो दंड इज ऑल्सो नीडेड. सो दंड चक्र ही ब्रिंग इन वाइल क्रिएटिंग द पॉट फ्रॉम क्ले. सो सच दर्शन इज देर दैट ही ब्रिंग्स देम टुगेदर. कैन ब्रह्म ब्रिंग टुगेदर एनी सामग्री? नो, कारणाज आर मिसिंग. मृदो व उपादान से स्वभिन्न कुलालादि सहाय दर्शनात्, एंड देन मृद व उपादान से, दिस मृद मृत इज वॉट उपादान कारण, विच इज वॉट स्वभिन्न स्वपदेन कुलाल, कुलाल भिन्न मृत इज देर. द क्ले इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द पॉट मेकर. सो दिस कुलालादि सहाय दर्शना, दि स्वभिन्न कुलालादि सहाय दर्शना मृदोवा. सो अदर वे, इट इज अदर वे, दिस मृत, कैन द मटीरियल कॉज इट सेल्फ बिकम अ पॉट? नो. सो स्वभिन्न इज स्वपदेन मृत, नॉट कुलाला, बिकॉज स्वभिन्न कुलाला हैज बीन सेट. सो स्वभिन्न कुलाला कैनॉट बी कुलाल भिन्न कुलाला. सो दैट इज वाई वा इज देर. वा मीन्स वन वे यू कैन से इज दैट विच वी हैव सीन इन द सूत्र. सूत्र मीनिंग वी सो एज वॉट दंड चक्र आदि उपसंहार दर्शनात् केन कुलालेन. सो द कुलाल बाय कुलाल देर इज उपसंहार. वी सी देर इज दर्शन, देर इज दर्शन, वी सी दैट देर इज उपसंहार संग्रह ऑफ दंड चक्र आदि. दिस इज द इंटरप्रिटेशन, विच फर्स्ट इंटरप्रिटेशन ओनली वन दैट वी सॉ इन द सूत्र. बट वृत्तिकार वृत्ति सेज देर इज अनदर पॉसिबिलिटी. What is that? Sahaya, he gives upasamhara, there is sahaya, says darshana of sahaya. There is a sight of some help. What kind of a help? For mrut. So mrut is a material cause. So efficient cause, the first interpretation, the efficient cause is dependent on danda chakra. They become sahakari karana and they are collected by the efficient cause. So efficient cause will need something else also. He'll need sahakari karana and material cause also. And material cause will also not become pot on its own. So that clay, mrut, which is material cause, mrudova upadanasya. Because see, upadanasya, you see, it is not strilinga. Mrut is strilinga. So mrudaha and upadanasya cannot be in samanadikaranam. They are not shashti. Therefore, upadana meaning this is what it appears to you. Mrut upadana karana. So it appears that they cannot be in samanadikaranam. But what has been done is that upadana is upadana karana. That upadana cannot become strilinga. So upadana karana, upadana shabda itself is what ana is ludanta. So it is napunsakalinga. But mrut is feminine. So mrudova upadanasya is what both are shashti, they are in samanadik. It appears they are not in samanadikaranyam, but mrut being nitya strilinga shabda and upadana also being nitya napunsakalinga shabda, they cannot change their gender. So from mrut there is utpatti, but of the mrudova upadanasya swabhinna kulaladi sahaya darshanat. So upadana karana has, what is that? Mrut. I'm just thinking how to translate. So generally off is the meaning that comes in mind. So this is why the issue with English language, it's there is no smooth flow. While there is a smooth flow in other languages and in Sanskrita, while reading this, some other shabda comes in also. To translate there is a difficulty, because off would work in many places, sambandha shashti iti kritva, but here mrudova upadanasya I cannot translate as off. So I was thinking how to put this. So if you see mrudova upadanasya swabhinna kulaladi sahaya darshanat, then you see there is some kind of a ekadesha anvaya also. It appears to be so, therefore there is no ease in translation also. So what is being said is that the mrut which is upadana karana has sahaya. So here you have to do the ekadesha anvaya. So upadana has sahaya of what? Swabhinna kulaladi. Swapadena mrut, which is upadana. So upadana karana mrud bhinna kulala is there. Kulala is bhinna from what? From upadana, which is mrut. And therefore what? Material cause also has help from kulala, who is different from itself. That is the meaning. And tasya darshanat, then you can say tasya darshanat. So there is a difficulty of Sanskrita also. There will be difficulty in making an anvaya, because there appears to be ekadesha anvaya here. In samasa it is done, but it is it is not done by students of vyakarana, because they are trying to learn. So generally it should not be done, but it is done by those who know vyakarana better than us. Their ekadesha anvaya is done. We see this in bhashya. So their people struggle to explain also and understand as well, because we try to do padachheda and then try to understand. That time it all goes together, but when you put the samasa together, then there is no anvaya possible. Why? What is ekadesha anvaya? For those who have this question, ekadesha anvaya, generally samasas have anvaya with another pada in such a manner that the last word will have anvaya. So upadanasya darshanat should be the anvaya, but here upadanasya sahaya seems to be the anvaya, not upadanasya darshanat. Upadanasya sahayam would be perhaps neuter. Tasya darshanat, then there is tasya darshanat, that seems to be the anvaya. Therefore it appears to be ekadesha anvaya to me with my limited knowledge, but it makes sense. So what has been said is that Purvapakshi is saying that kulala, who is efficient cause, will need help from material cause and other sahakari karanas, and mrut will also not become karya on its own. It will need help from swabhinna, someone else, and who is that someone? Is the efficient cause kulala, and other things also. Kulala adi padena, again danda chakra is needed. So for mrut to become ghata, sentient kulala, for insentient mrut to become ghata, sentient kulala, who is different from this insentient mrut, as well as danda chakra is needed. And from the sutra, upasamhara being taken as sangraha cannot be done by mrut. Therefore from the efficient causes perspective, the kulala will also need what? Danda chakradi. Here also if you look at it, there is an ekadesha anvaya. not kartuhu darshanat. You can say kartu darshanat also, but kartuhu kartra upasamhar darshanat. So here it seems to be a better so it appears better here. If you want to avoid ekadeshan vaya, now another thing comes to mind. You can say upadanasya darshanat can be an anvaya. So there is a possibility. Now I see that you can do without ekadeshan vaya. Kaise upadanasya mrudaha darshanat, then mrut is shasht, mrudaha is shashti, upadanasya is also shashti with linga bheda of course. But what kind of a darshana upadanasya darshanat which has sahaya? So there is some struggle there also to translate, but I hope you get the idea. The basic idea is that efficient cause will need material cause which is different from the efficient cause, as well as other sahakari karanas, danda chakradi. Similarly, other way around also, material cause will also need help from sahakari karanas, danda chakradi, which can be done only with a with aid from sentient kulala, who is different from the material cause. So both ways you go, there cannot be a single karana, whether material or efficient, whether nimitta karana or upadana karana, there cannot be a single karana without any help from other sentient or insentient, and thereby produce karya. This is the objection by the Purvapakshi. Tad ubhay vilakshanasya brahmanah na jagat kartrutvam upadanatvam va sambhavati. Tad ubhay vilakshanasya brahmanah. This Brahma is what? Brahma is ubhaya bhinna, is different from both. Ubhaya vilakshanasya, just give me a moment, whether it is vilakshana or avilakshana, let me just chetanam. So ubhaya vilakshana is, yeah, it is ubhaya vilakshana only. So what is ubhaya vilakshana? This Brahma is ubhaya vilakshana, meaning swabhinna chetana and swabhinna achetana. Swabhinna achetana would be what? Upadana karana. This Brahma cannot be mrut. Mrut is what? Mrut is, in the example, if you look at this, Brahma is different from mrut. Mrut is insentient. Brahma is sentient. So swabhinna achetana upadana karana is mrut. That sahaya is needed. Meaning help from mrut is needed by Brahma to make ghata. Meaning you take in the example, it should be extended to the exemplified prapancha. So something like a material cause like mrut is needed, which is different from Brahma. Tad ubhaya vilakshanasya brahmana. And then if you take the kulala who is sentient, and thereby you say, oh, Brahma is like kulala who is nimitta karana. He is different from that also. Why? Swa bhinna chetana. Svabhinna chetana nimitta karana asaya. So just in the example, what we saw is that material cause need helps from efficient cause. At least that much help is needed. We'll look at this. For simplicity, we'll say sahakari karana will set aside. The Brahma tattva is what? It is one without a second. And what example shows is that material cause, whether Brahma is, if Brahma is material cause, then it will need something different from material cause that is not existent for to be efficient cause. If Brahma is efficient cause, then Brahma will need something other than itself, which is material cause. That is not there. Why? Brahmana ekarupatvat. So ekarupa Brahma cannot have something which is different from itself, as whether it is material cause or efficient cause or sahakari karana, something which help, instrumental to producing the karya. So thereby tad ubhaya vilakshanasya brahmana na jagat kartrutvam upadanatvam va sambhavati. There is no such possibility of Brahma, that kind of a Brahma becoming Upadana Karana. Sorry. Ataha, therefore what? Ataha samanvaya virudhyate iti chet iti purva paksha. So the, thereby there is samanvaya virodha as ekarupa Brahma be karana for any kind of prapancha, any karya. Siddhantastu, Siddhanta says kshiravadhi, he shabda hetvartha. So he is because we see in loka that kshira is one, without any help it curdles. After curd has been added, it does not become curd immediately. So there is something that is happening that kshira is doing. Whatever, whether it is morphing or whatever you say, some chemical reaction is going on, whatever you say, you can give any explanation, but you do not see that explanation. When I ask you why did it not curdle immediately, if the help was needed, then that help was given. Why did it not curdle immediately? So there is something that is happening after the curd has been added, that is all done by kshira, the milk itself, and there is no help needed. Other than kshira, no sentient or insentient karana is needed, no sahakari karana is needed to curdle itself. So kshiravadi, he shabda hetvartha, it's a hetu, he means yatmat karana. Yatha loke kshiram baihya sadhanani anapekshya gadhya karana parinamate. And I have explained this as baihya sadhana not being needed is what? After the curd has been added. That is the example. As seen in the world, the milk, without expecting any external means, by itself it transforms into dadi. And we can even say, if at all there is still an objection or difficulty in understanding, you can say that I don't need any help for anyone to add curd to milk. In fact, if you don't even open the milk packet and you bring milk, you don't open the milk packets that are available, plastic sealed packs, just leave it outside, especially in this kind of a summer, you leave it for only some hours, and especially it should be expiry of that day, it will curdle. The reason I am saying this example comes to mind because I faced this multiple times when I went to my brother's place for these 3 weeks. I was not used to, you know, handling milk, putting that in the fridge, because timings are different, milk is, everything is different. So I have a short memory in such things. I am absent minded. So I forgot at least one sachet of that pack of milk, which was actually meant to curdle. So other milk he uses for tea, etc., to drink milk. But then the one packet is set aside for curd, and that was not boiled. I forgot to boil it, and I forgot to put it in the fridge also. I prepared breakfast, I served, I went, and I was relaxing. Then suddenly I recalled, I went there, and it was not even afternoon, the milk had curdled. I looked at the date was that particular day's expiry, best before that particular date, so it had curdled. So no curd was added. How did this milk curdle without any help from anything else other than itself? So that can be an example to drive home the point as to kshiram baihya sadhanani anapekshya dadya karana parinamate tadvat brahma api. Similarly, Brahma also can become karya as though, again as though, because kalpita bheda, that the paramasiddhanta should not be compromised. So while saying that, as though should come to the mind, even if it is anucharita, not mentioned, it should come to the mind that all this parinama is what? It is parinama is vivarta, there is no real change. Shruti rapi brahmana asayasya karyakarityam darshayati. This Brahma, we have explained logically as ekarupa Brahma becoming karya without any sahaya. But all that logical explanation is based on Shruti. So Shruti rapi brahmana asayasya brahmana, that Brahma who is having no help from anything else, whether material or efficient cause who is different from itself, that kind of a Brahma who is helpless as per you, that helpless Brahma himself has karya karyatvam, meaning he is karya kari. He is the one who creates the karya in the form of prapancha. Karya karyatvam darshayati shrutihi na tasya karyam karanam na vidyate iti. And we are accepting that there is no sahaya for this Brahma. It is neither wanted nor needed. It is that kind of a Brahma who has no karana, but karya karyatvam is there. Na tasya karyam karanam cha vidyate iti shruti darshayati. So it shows that there is no, and actually we will say that na tasya karyam vidyate means in reality there is no karya, meaning it has not really changed, but there is still karya karyatvam without having karana. So that is the reply. And here if you look at it, what does it mean? So here there can be objection as to na tasya karyam vidyate, means brahmana karyam na vidyate. Here karyam, see karya and karana or karya and karana are going to, generally karana is a word used, when they come together in a single sentence, there the meaning is not literal as a karya meaning the way we think that jagat is, because in this context it appears to be confusing. That can be paramasiddhanta, but the shruti is not saying that. Shruti is saying what? Na tasya brahmana karyam karanam cha vidyate, means karya is sharira and karana is taken as these antakkaranadi, all the karanas means whether you take jnanendriyas, karmendriyas, antakkarana buddhi inclusive, manaha buddhi inclusive. So with these both words you can differentiate, and karya is needed, why sharira is needed. Without sharira you cannot use karanas. Even if you have karanas, let's say I have sense organs, but I don't have the body where the sense organs can be within. So karya is sharira, which has to become the adhikarana for karanas to be in. So if you recall from Tattva Bodha, there is a sharira. What is this? Stula sharira. So karya is stula sharira and karana is sukshma sharira. That is the meaning you have to take here. Natasya meaning tasya brahmanaha stula shariram nasti sukshma shariram api nasti cha na vidyate, means nasti ityartha. Both are not there and still karya karyatvam darshayati. Shruti does say that Brahma is karana, jagat is its karya. So this karya does not, jagat is not its karya. That is not the statement. The Brahma, so this tasya is sambandha, sambandha shruti. So does not have sharira, stula sharira, or sharira meaning karana, which is sukshma sharira. So without sukshma sharira being there, in that kind of a stula sharira which was expected, that also not being there, still Brahma is karyakari, meaning Brahma creates the prapancha. Nanu chetanatve sati asayatvam hetuhu. So now Purvapakshi is saying, wait, there is a different hetu. When I said asayatvat, because he had given a hetu as what? Asayatvat. I'll just take 2 minutes. We started 2 minutes late and I just want to see if we can at least look at the introduction here. So he's saying asayatvam. Asayatvam is the hetu, asayatvat, meaning Brahmana asayatvat, because Brahma does not have any help from anything or anyone else, whether as material, efficient or supporting causes. Therefore Brahma cannot be a karana at all. He cannot, he or it cannot create anything. Purva Pakshi is refining the hetu, which is acceptable. He says when I say asayatvam, it is not only asayatvam, it is chetanatve sati asayatvam as hetu. So he is saying being chetana and asaya. Your example is what? Kshira. That is a counter example. You have countered my tarka with one single example which is sufficient. If you can show kshira is becoming dadhi without help from others, thereby Brahma can also. So then he said what? Tadvat Brahma api. That is what the Siddhanti said. So he's saying, you Siddhantiya, you are giving Tadvat Brahma api, but Tadvat Brahma is sentient. Whereas Tadvat, when you are saying Kshiravat, Kshira is insentient. So you cannot give an insentient example to the sentient Brahma not being a Karana without help. Let it be that an insentient without help, it is transforming itself, but the sentient cannot change or become a Karana for any Karya without having help. This is the argument that I have been trying to make with my Hetu as Asayatva, but you have turned it around by giving an insentient example. It is not acceptable to me. So he is saying, I am going to refine my Hetu. My Hetu is not Asayatvat. My Hetu is Chetanatve Sati Asayatvat. Being Chetana and having no help, that kind of an entity cannot become Karana for any Karya. So you give me an example where you see Chetana, which is Karana without any help, and thereby becoming or creating some Karya. Atah na kshire vyabhichara ityashankya chetana drishtantena tasya vyabhicharam ah. So Siddhanti says, okay, with your refined Hetu also I can work as to chetana padartha, chetana something which is sentient and has no help, cannot become Karana for something. If that is the objection, I will give you an example of Chetana also without help creating Karyas, doing something. Therefore, Kshira cannot be an example where Vyabhichara of my Hetu is shown, because my Hetu has another Visheshana, which is Chetana. So Chetana Asayatvat, that is the Hetu. So if you split that Visheshana, it will be Chetanatve Sati Asayatvat. We have seen this in Tarka Sangraha or Padakritya Ityadi. So I'll just explain this, because there will be a doubt as to what this is. I'll just cover the sutra. Deva Adivad Api Loke. So Deva Adivad Api Loke. What is that Loke in the world? Deva Adivad Api. So Tadvat Brahma Api. Deva Adivad Brahma Api. So there Tadvat was Kshiravat. So he says Kshira I cannot accept as an example where there is Hetu Vyabhichara, Tarka Vyabhichara. I'll show that you show me sentient example. So he says, okay, Devadivat, Devapitruvat, Brahma Api. So what is this? Says that the Devas or Pitru Ityadi, what happens? They are Chetana. You cannot say Deva is not Chetana, Pitara are not Chetana. So they also, using their own Siddhis, there are no Manushya limitations, Manushya kind of limitations. Some other limitations are there, but then Devas and Pitruganas, they do not have our kind of limitations. So they are Siddha, they have more Siddhis. So what do? With Sankalpa itself, they create something. They are also, there is also Vaichitra, Karya Vaichitram, not only a single Karya, they can have many Karyas without any help. Why? No Karanas are needed. There is absolutely nothing else needed. With just Sankalpa, they can bless you with something. That's why when we make Pitrugana happy by Shraddha Karma Ityadi, they give us something. Why do we do Deva Puja Ityadi? Why should we do? Because that Devata blesses us. Of course, in Paramasiddhanta, the Ishvara himself, Parabrahma, Paramatma himself blesses us in various forms. But then, do you see the upadhi of Deva, upadhi of Pitrus based on Dharma Shastra? Do you do their Puja or Shraddha Karma Ityadi? They become happy and bless us. And while blessing us, do they say, okay, I'll bring some help from someone else, something else? No. No sahakari karana, no nimitta or upadana karana separate from themselves is needed. And this should be acceptable too. So we'll say sammatavat. It is acceptable. You cannot object that no devatas take help from others to bless. No, they don't. Pitrus also do not take help from anything or anyone. They just bless us by sankalpa matra. Sankalpa matrena. So that is the sutra. We'll see the vritti in the next part. sorry for the delay. Amna Indra Samsiddham Adi Madhyanta Varjitam Ananda Karma Apurnam Atmit Jyoti Rupasmihe. Namaste, Dhanyavada. Sorry for the delay.
Okay, thank you, friend. Yeah. Namaste.